Hey YouTube, Joyboy here. So, I honestly couldn't imagine a better time for this video. You know it is very relevant right now based on the latest chapter. And we're going to be talking about a lot of things related to this as well. But, you know, what exactly does Luffy need to do in order to defeat a Yonko to become truly Yonko level? And right now, where does he stand against other commanders? But yeah, let's talk about the last chapter. And I think that it is important to power scale Luffy, Queen, Kaido, and Big Mom. Oda has now drawn a line in the sand. There is now no doubt about how absurdly powerful Yonko are. Anybody who is not a Yonko stands basically no chance against a Yonko, at least from the ranks of pirates. But what about the admirals, JB? Stop it. We're not talking about the admirals. We're not even bringing this in the conversation. It's not relevant. I don't even want to go there. We're talking about pirates. Here's what we know about Queen. Queen is a zone type double fruit user, which means as a zone type, he has heightened physical strength, speed, and endurance granted by his fruit. In particular, based on the type of zone that he has, I would say that his strength more than anything else lies in defense. Strength, but not so much speed. Aside from this, I think that we can surmise that Queen has access to, at the very least, all of the basic forms of Haki, potentially even Conquerors. I could see Queen with Conquerors, although that is not confirmed. But he certainly has observation, and he has armament to some degree of proficiency. We've also learned, based on the fight between Luffy and Katakuri, Katakuri had stronger armament Haki than Luffy, and I think that that is a trait of simply using it more, having more experience. So in my mind, Queen probably has stronger armament than Luffy as well. But whether or not he has advanced forms, or so-called advanced forms of Haki, such as Future Sight, or the projectile, the Force Haki that Luffy is trying to master now, that is uncertain. Queen's only real feat since being introduced into the story is stopping a blow from Luffy relatively easy. But the thing about this is that at the time Luffy was angry, and I doubt that he was concentrating, that he was focusing, so more than likely his ability to use Observation Haki or Future Sight Haki was compromised in that moment. I think that it is also important to point out that Luffy was not using Gear 2nd, he was not using Gear 4th, and those two things are hugely important for Luffy to have a base increase in both power and speed. Queen seemed to have no issue dealing with Luffy's punch from a speed standpoint, from a power standpoint, but that doesn't really mean anything because Luffy wasn't going anywhere near all out. And I personally believe that he would need to in order to fight on par with somebody of Queen's stature. Who also, again, it's worth pointing out, was not going all out, was not even using his Devil Fruit abilities yet. So yeah, I think that is really hard, basically impossible to power scale Luffy versus Queen or Queen's true power level based on this feat alone. For me, the best gauge is to actually look at other Yonko commanders that we may know more of and how they stack up with Luffy. This is just something that I believe to be generally true. It's a rule that I follow. But the Yonkos compete against each other. They are stated to be rivals of each other. They prevent the other one from conquering the entirety of the New World. And so with this being in mind, a Yonko would need to be able to fight against another Yonko, and Yonko commanders would need to be able to fight on par with other Yonko commanders. So now we're going to delve into a bit of my own headcanon, where we are ranking the Beast Pirates against the Big Mom Pirates. And guys, in my opinion, based on what we've seen from Whole Cake Island, and what we've seen from the Big Mom Pirates, I think that there are more strong members of the Big Mom Pirates, but Kaido and his Calamities are stronger one for one than their counterparts. It's stated in the story that in a one-on-one fight, you should always bet on Kaido. That means in a one-on-one fight, whoever it might be, Kaido versus Big Mom, you should bet on Kaido. In my opinion, I take this as truth, in my opinion, Kaido fights Big Mom with no extraneous factors, no shenanigans in play. Kaido defeats Big Mom. It is not an overwhelming defeat. Kaido does not easily defeat Big Mom, but he does defeat her. The reason why I believe this is pretty simple. It has everything to do with portrayal. Oda, without actually showing Kaido fight, is communicating to us about his power level compared to the other current Yonko. He says to bet on them. I believe Oda. We never heard anybody say that in a one-on-one fight you should bet on Big Mom. Now honestly guys, it's pretty hard to rationalize this fully because we just don't know enough about the Calamities to power scale them. As I said before, I mean, we have one feat from Queen and a couple feats from Jack and no feats at all from King. So why am I saying that Kaido's Calamities are stronger than Big Mom's commanders? This has everything to do with evening the playing field and making Kaido's crew equal to Big Mom's crew. Because as I said before, over the last 20 years, I think that Big Mom would need to be comparable to Kaido in order to not just completely be annihilated by him. So here in the moment, everyone's talking about the smile, and they're talking about, you know, the headliners and the new supernova that have joined Kaido. Guys, these have only been part of Kaido's crew for a very short time. The direction that the story seems to be taking, how I am interpreting it, is that the balance of powers is slightly shifting in the favor of Kaido in the current timeline. He's using Doflamingo and using Caesar to acquire these smiles to make his crew significantly more powerful. But even before he acquired this, he was on par with Big Mom and all of the known powerful children. So keeping in mind that over the last 20, 30 years, Kaido and Big Mom have been equals. Big Mom has been able to birth a child almost every single year, and she sometimes has more than one. And so I consider the vast majority of Big Mom's children, if we're thinking of this like a game, right? We're playing a One Piece video game, One Piece armies. Most of Big Mom's children are essentially hero pieces. They are very strong. And they, for the most part, comprise the power of her forces. I think she has more heroes than anybody else. And so if you consider Kaido and Big Mom in the past to have been roughly equals, and Big Mom has more hero pieces, then Kaido must have stronger heroes. Without considering that in a one-on-one fight, Kaido may beat Big Mom herself. And this is while throwing in that Kaido's calamities have higher bounties than Big Mom's sweet commanders. Now, the bounty is not the end-all, be-all determinant of strength. There's a lot that goes into it, but I think that this could be an indicator that, as well, that the calamities are just stronger than the sweet commanders. Again, maybe not significantly stronger. I don't see any of the calamities making Katakuri look bad, but strong enough to defeat them in a one-on-one fight, just the same as Kaido would defeat Big Mom in a one-on-one fight. The end result, at the very least, has to be roughly a stalemate. But I just said that the balance of power is shifting, and that's because I think that Kaido has been amassing power as of the last 5-6 years at a greater rate than the Big Mom pirates. While Big Mom is still producing children who will grow up into hero pieces, Kaido has obtained the Smile Devil Fruits and essentially has transformed his fodder into decent fighters. Now guys, just brutal honesty here, I don't rank most of the headliners very highly. But as your base piece, or as a fodder piece in your army, they are incredibly powerful. And this matters in this hypothetical game of One Piece armies. An example that I think really substantiates the idea of this actually comes from the Big Mom Pirates herself. Big Mom stated that she thought that she could defeat Kaido and Shanks and become the king of the pirates if only Lola proceeded with her marriage and Big Mom got the strength of the Elbaf Giants. The Elbaf Giants are incredibly powerful fodder pieces, potentially with some heroes as well. Adding their forces to Big Mom, Big Mom perceived it as being a turning point, a tipping point. But obviously that failed. For Kaido, the turning point or the tipping point, I think, is Smile. And to a lesser extent, probably the supernova that he has recently recruited. Over the last 2 years, Big Mom recruited Capone and then failed to retain him. And then she also lost Aruge, as well as Kid and Luffy, while Kaido has actually recruited Apu, Basil Hawkins, Killer, and X-Drake. And hell, as of 20 years ago, you can even throw Wano into this. Now, I think that Wano is incredibly complicated because they don't know that he's a pirate and they're not really a part of his army in the same way, but they certainly defend him in Wano. He uses Wano as his base and it becomes incredibly hard. Even if Big Mom may have been slightly stronger than Kaido in the past with all of her hero pieces, going into Wano kind of evens the scale, similar to how Big Mom thought that recruiting the Giants would tip the scales in her favor. I think that Elbaf and Wano are pretty comparable in that they are two of the very most powerful independent nations. So getting them on your side matters, and in this case points to Kaido, no points to Big Mom. But I don't think that Kaido could use Wano offensively. And the last thing that I consider is I consider complacency. Guys, just in my honest opinion, the Big Mom Pirates have a smell about them, a look about them, that they might be a bit complacent. That Big Mom had these giant, huge dreams when she was younger, of creating a paradise and making the world a better place, and she settled just short of what it is that she hoped to achieve. She created her paradise, she created Totlin, she realized she couldn't do much more than that and called it good. When you look at all of the Big Mom pirates, generally speaking, the old ones, some of the firstborn, are most of the strongest Big Mom pirates. I think that it's important to keep in mind that these were the children who were most vital, who were most significant in creating Totlin and creating Big Mom's dynasty in the first place. Obviously along with Big Mom herself, but when you get to the younger generations, you find the Big Mom Pirates, I think, steadily getting weaker and weaker. I think that's complacency. They're not needed to be that strong. As Luffy is kind of learning now, power blooms in times of great duress. And the younger Big Mom Pirates didn't go through those crucial battles that the older ones did, and therefore maybe a little bit weaker in general. Meanwhile, for the most part, Big Mom is eating cake, she's drinking tea, and she's throwing parties and weddings. Hatching schemes to try and amass power, but I don't think really going out and fighting. That's her lifestyle. Meanwhile, I think that the Kaido Pirates are portrayed much differently. They still seem to hunger for success and put themselves in situations in which they may grow. So that's pretty much my thoughts about the Beast Pirates versus the Big Mom Pirates 20 years ago and today, and I think that that is relevant. So now we're talking about Luffy, and Luffy has faced off against the Sweet Commanders. So at the end of Dressrosa and at the beginning of Whole Cake Island, I really do believe that Luffy was not quite Commander level. Or if he was just barely. I think that if Luffy was a member of the Big Mom Pirates, he would certainly be competitive with Cracker and with Snack and compete for that third or fourth commander spot. But it'd be a bit dicey. So what exactly gives me this thought? Well, let's start off with Dressrosa. I think that Doflamingo is a hero piece and also very nearly commander level. He's like Perro Sparrow or Oven or Daifuku, somewhere around there. Luffy absolutely obliterated him while in Gear 4th in terms of speed, in terms of strength. He made Doflamingo look silly, but the problem with Gear 4th is that it has a very limited time that Luffy can use it. He has about 2 minutes or so to operate within it, and if he doesn't defeat his opponent in that time, it didn't look very good for him at the beginning of Whole Cake Island at the end of Dressrosa. I think that realistically, if you are being honest with yourselves in a one-on-one fight with no intervention whatsoever, I think that there's a very good case to be made that Doflamingo might have defeated Luffy after Gear 4th ran out the first time. Either way, it was really close. Either way, my takeaway from this is that in terms of strength and speed, while in Gear 4th, Luffy is probably stronger than most commanders. However, the issue is that he can only do this in very short bursts, which is the downside. And that evens the playing field. I think that it's pretty apparent that if Luffy could maintain Gear 4th indefinitely, he most likely would have basically fodderized, low-diffed Doflamingo. And I think that the same thing carries true for Luffy's fight against Cracker, where it appeared as though he was both stronger and faster physically than Cracker, but Cracker had the ability to stall and to prevent Luffy from defeating him within the time of Gear 4th, which made the proposition of Luffy defeating him very, very difficult. Certainly, it might have been possible if Luffy went all out, but it was like close. It was going to be close, in my opinion. And ultimately, Luffy didn't defeat him because he didn't go all out. He rather played the long game with the help of Nami, weakening Cracker's biscuits, and then took advantage of him while saving energy. So I'm going to go out on a limb here. I know that we haven't seen Smoothie fight, but I don't think that she has any advanced forms of Haki. I think that if Luffy could maintain Gear 4th indefinitely, he would relatively easily defeat Cracker and Smoothie. The difficult opponent comes with the number one, comes with Katakuri, because of his ability to see the future. If Luffy could maintain Gear 4th forever, without being able to see the future yet, I think that the Katakuri Luffy fight is very, very interesting. I think that it's very, very close. I think Luffy is probably stronger and faster than Katakuri, but Katakuri has more advanced Haki, he has stronger armament Haki, and in general, just seems to be a pretty strong and fast guy in the first place. To my eyes, irregardless of bounty, there seems to be a pretty large gap between Katakuri and Big Mom's other Sweet Commanders based on advanced Haki alone. Luffy might have been stronger and faster than Katakuri while in Gear 4th, but it didn't matter because Katakuri could predict his moves and wait it out until Gear 4th ran out, so Luffy was going to lose to Katakuri. But this, I think, is where everything really began to drastically and quickly change. As we saw from that fight, at first, Katakuri was more interested in crushing Luffy's will than actually defeating him. In every moment that Katakuri could have had to end that fight, he chose not to because he wanted Luffy to submit. And a lot of people had issues with this, but you need to keep in mind that recruiting Luffy to the Big Mom Pirates would be crucial in the greater fight, the Yonko Army's One Piece game that we've been talking about. You want to recruit these up-and-comers onto your crew, and I think that Katakuri is used to doing that whenever he would be put in a fight like this. Kaido recruits X-Drake and Basil Hawkins and Apu and Killer and hopefully Kid. Big Mom wants to do the same thing. So Katakuri, deeming himself significantly and safely stronger, chooses, rather than just straight up end the fight and defeat Luffy, tries to, in this moment, crush his will. And in the process, comes to have a respect for Luffy's indomitable spirit. Like I said, guys, Katakuri's probably done things like this a lot in the past. Big Mom Pirates have been relevant for 30 years, if not longer. And Luffy did enough to impress Katakuri. Even though Katakuri's initial plan was to crush Luffy's spirit and defeat him in the name of the Big Mom Pirates, he found himself, over the course of this fight, quietly rooting for him, hoping that he would continue to get up and continue to impress him. I don't think that Katakuri could believe the amount of spirit and the amount of will that Luffy possesses. Beaten down time and time again, he always gets back up. With no strength left, he gets back up. With no strength left, he finds more strength. I think that Katakuri learned that there is no such thing as crushing Luffy's will. If Luffy is to lose, he is to die. And I do think that Katakuri had the opportunity to, in this moment, kill Luffy because he could, but he chose not to. Because it changed from a battle of who will be the winner or loser, who could kill the other person, but a battle of endurance, who could outwill the other. And so it is also because of this that Luffy was able to grow pretty substantially, almost exponentially, I think, from this fight. I think really it transformed from a boss battle into a training arc. And so guys, I know that this is very divisive and not everybody is going to agree with me, but I think that when Katakuri gave himself his own fatal wound after he had fatally injured Luffy, fatally put that in quotation marks, that essentially put them on an even playing field. So at the end of the arc, when Luffy defeated Katakuri, what I think Oda is communicating here is that although the fight was not completely legit, it had all sorts of convolution and complication, I think by the end of the fight, what Oda is communicating is that Luffy overcame him. Luffy became stronger than him. Or at the very least, the ability to fight him evenly. But the extent of which this is true is kind of debatable, it's kind of questionable, and we're not 100% sure about this. But I think that definitely, for me, definitely, while in Gear 4th, with Future Side Hockey, Luffy defeats Katakuri. But the issue with Gear 4th comes up again, that it is only a burst, it is not a state that Luffy can maintain fully. I think that Katakuri was able to overcome the speed and the strength advantage Luffy has while in Gear 4th because of his Future Side Hockey. Luffy having it now, even if it isn't fully mastered to the level of somebody like Katakuri, I think that it is mostly mastered, but even if it's not quite on his level, I think that while in Gear 4th, using Future Side Hockey, Luffy defeats Katakuri. He is stronger power level wise. Now, if they were both 100% in fighting today, could Luffy defeat Katakuri before his Gear 4th timeline ran out? Is he strong enough in his base form in order to truly buy time if Katakuri was intent on defeating him, on killing him? It's kind of sketchy, but I'd put the fight close. So in my opinion, guys, as of the end of Whole Cake Island, Luffy is as strong as a Sweet Commander who is considerably stronger than the other Sweet Commanders. So obviously here, where Katakuri aligns with the Calamities matters. Is Katakuri, competitive with King, but stronger than Queen and Jack? These are things that we don't know, but I think that it all comes down to essentially advanced hockey. Because Katakuri has advanced hockey, he has great base physical strength and speed, even though he doesn't have a zone fruit. But because of his Future Side Hockey, that automatically puts him on a tier above anybody else who does not also possess advanced hockey. So let's say that Queen and Jack do not have Future Side Hockey. They also don't have advanced armament hockey. In my opinion, even if the fight lasts 10 days, right? Because they're both zone type users, so they have enhanced physical attributes, speed, strength, and endurance. Katakuri would eventually defeat them because of his ability to see the future. Assuming that he doesn't lose his concentration, lose his cool, lose his focus. But this is just frankly something that we do not know. We do not know the capabilities, the full capabilities of Jack, Queen, and King. But going back from my logic earlier, it is in my opinion that Kaido's heroes, Kaido's calamities are stronger than Big Mom's Sweet Commanders. I'm going to go ahead and go on a limb here and say that all three of them, Jack, Queen, and King, would fight on a pretty even playing field with Katakuri, with King being stronger than Katakuri. Definitely. So with that being said, if Luffy were to fight Queen right now, Queen obviously has a zone type. So the strength, defense, endurance, and speed is heightened. We don't know whether or not he has an advanced form of hockey, but I would wager a guess that he might have one, but definitely not both. That would just be like a comparison of Luffy versus Katakuri today, a redo. And which I said earlier, it's kind of sketchy. In my opinion, it would be a close fight. So if Luffy fights Queen relatively evenly, I think that the power scaling actually makes a ton of sense what Oda has recently done with Big Mom defeating Queen very quickly in a matter of a couple hits. First off, Kaido used a named move, which seemed to be a pretty significant blow against Luffy, and it one-shot him. Luffy was down for the count with one hit. Big Mom, on the other hand, used unnamed moves. It just seemed to be general attacks on Queen and did not one-shot him, but still defeated him very quickly. And again, it's also worth pointing out that she defeated him, but he was not down for the count. It was just very clear that he was never going to defeat her. As Kaido was strong enough to defeat Luffy in one hit, who is his roughly an equal to Queen in my mind, then Big Mom defeating Queen quickly, but not in a one-shot, using less powerful moves, makes sense. That is just how strong the Yonko are. It is truly baffling to me to see people crying on social media about Big Mom defeating Queen in this way, when these same people thought that Kaido would defeat Luffy just like this. It's like people don't appreciate the amount of growth that Luffy has gone through all of Whole Cake Island. This entire training arc at the end of Whole Cake Island that Luffy went through was so that he could be on this level now, be a contemporary to somebody like Queen. Big Mom may be weaker than Kaido, but she is not significantly weaker than Kaido. That fight would still be very, very good. It would be very, very close. They both make other commanders look silly. And Luffy right now is at commander level, no doubt, in my mind. But I think another part of this conversation is that people really hoped for Luffy to overcome the commanders officially. The Katakuri fight has all sorts of caveats on it. The Cracker fight has all sorts of caveats on it. And I think people do want to see Luffy face off against a commander in a legit fight, like a Lucci fight. And we're not going to get it now. It doesn't appear as though. And I think that people are missing it. People were looking for that and are kind of disappointed we're not going to get that. But I kind of have an explanation for this, at least my understanding of maybe where Oda is going with the Wano arc and why he may be pursuing it in this way. Guys, just my opinion, but Luffy's time of fighting commanders was in Whole Cake Island. Now that we're in Wano, Luffy needs to begin to set his sights on the Yonko, and he can't get bogged down by any of their subordinates now. I mean, he can fight them, sure, but I no longer think that it's an important step for him. I think that the Katakuri fight was that defining moment of now Luffy needs to set his sights higher. The Yonko are here, and they are Luffy's opponent. Guys, I guess I just find it very significant that given the opportunity, Oda decided to trade out a Luffy versus Queen fight for a Luffy versus Big Mom fight. It's like saying these are the people that we should be concerned about fighting. And I think a relevant question surrounding this is, obviously Luffy is beginning to master the other kind of advanced armament haki. How does that play into a potential fight with Queen, and how much stronger does it potentially really make him? So I guess we'll start off with Future Sight haki. Guys, if you've mastered Future Sight haki, then really it's just a question of speed, and you could potentially dodge your opponent indefinitely. As far as we are aware, it is the ultimate evasive technique that could also be used offensively as well. Being able to predict your opponent means that you can evade them and then set up potentially hurting them as well. But mainly its strength would lie in evasion, and theoretically you could fight somebody indefinitely if they were not fast enough to essentially negate your ability to see what it is that they are about to do. And so the other kind of advanced haki, the Force haki, has already been suggested in Wano to be what Luffy needs in order to potentially damage a Yonko who are supposedly undamageable. So we saw Luffy fight Kaido earlier in this arc in Gear 4th. He tried every number of attacks that he possibly could and didn't leave a scratch on Kaido. If he masters this kind of haki, I suppose that he could actually damage him. And the very same would apply to Big Mom. But I think another low-key element of this that not a lot of people think of is you can also use this defensively as well. When Rayleigh demonstrated this technique during the two-year time skip, an elephant actually tried to attack him. And he used his hand in the very same posture that we see Luffy at the end of this chapter, in more of a deflect stance, using the Force to stop an opponent's blow. So it's both simultaneously offense and defense. So in terms of haki, mastering these two advanced forms makes one a master of offense, defense, and evasion. Guys, we're about to delve way into the realm of the unknown. And this is just a gut feeling that I have that I think that many people are going to disagree with just because, you know, everyone has their thoughts about this. But I don't think the Big Mom nor Kaido have either forms of advanced Haki. Big Mom and Kaido are prodigies. They are our physical freaks of nature. I think that they were basically born unbeatable. As we've seen in Rayleigh flashbacks, time and time again, your Haki blooms during difficult fights, and I don't think that Big Mom nor Kaido have had very many of these. I know people will say that Kaido has been captured, you know, X number of times, he's been defeated, you know, 7 times, something like that. But I think that Kaido has turned himself in a lot, and I think that he has been, you know, quadruple teamed by entire pirate crews going solo and all sorts of shenanigans, so none of those fights are really legit. And I think another thing to keep in mind is that just as we saw in the last example in the last chapter when Luffy's Haki bloomed, it's under times of great duress, times of great stress. Luffy absolutely wanted to save Grandpa Hiyo, and in order to do that, his Haki needed to bloom. And personally, I don't get the vibe that Kaido would be stressed in quite the same way that Luffy would have been. In order to bloom his Haki, right, he's not concerned whether he gets defeated or not. He's not concerned about any of his crew, it doesn't appear as though, so there's no real need to bloom. I would say almost for sure to me, it doesn't seem to make sense that he would be able to bloom future sight Haki, because that sort of is like an indicator of reliance on evasion when Kaido doesn't need to evade, he just defends. This is how I make sense of Shanks being a Yonko and competitive with freaks like Big Mom and Kaido. I don't think that Shanks is necessarily as fast and as strong as someone like Kaido or Big Mom, these prodigies. I think that Shanks matches them because of his mastery of Haki. And that would also explain why he doesn't need his other arm, why it is really not all that important to his fighting capabilities. Guys, I'm really curious to know the answer for this for sure, but I have a feeling that these advanced forms of Haki are a lot rarer than maybe we think that they are right now. Back in Old Cake Island in the Big Mom Pirates, how many of them displayed Force Haki? None of them did. And how many of them had Future Sight Haki? Only one, and it was explained to be a big deal, and Big Mom did not display the same ability. She even looked at Katakuri like, you know, what is going on during the tea party? These advanced forms of Haki are rare. Luffy mastering them is a big deal. Honestly, guys, I would not be surprised to learn or be surprised to hear that mastering both of these advanced kinds of Haki would essentially make Luffy a Yonko level fighter. This being a feat that only somebody like Shanks or somebody else who isn't just absurdly powerful like Big Mom or Kaido, but is on a Yonko's level, would have been able to achieve. Meaning this is not a trait of a commander. Maybe some of the toughest commanders, Katakuri, Queen, and King, have one, but not both. And having both is important. As we sort of suggested earlier, these two kinds of advanced forms of Haki added together complement each other perfectly. They form almost an unbreakable defense and an unstoppable offense. If you just look at Force Haki as an example, you can stop anything and you can hurt anything, but that doesn't do you any good if somebody is fast enough to avoid you or can see what you do before you do it and get around it. That is why Future Sight Haki matters. But at the same time, Future Sight Haki may allow you to evade anyone and set up potential attacks, but without the other kind of advanced kind of Haki, then you may not be able to damage them properly, or they may be able to stop your attacks. So just to get to the point here, guys, I think that once Luffy has the ability to use this Force Haki upon command, he will have surpassed the Yonko commanders. He may fight them, but I think that the point of the fight would be to demonstrate that Luffy has surpassed them. It's time to move on to bigger fish. And then Luffy's crew, which needs to grow almost as much as he does, then takes on the mantle of facing the Yonko commanders, because truly that is their role as a part of the Straw Hat Pirates. Luffy fights the Yonko, and Zoro and Sanji fight the commanders. This is how the hypothetical game of One Piece armies works. Luffy is now a playable general, the fifth Yonko. But although it might have sounded a bit confusing, I want to clarify, just because Luffy has mastered this ability, I don't think automatically makes him a Yonko level. I just think that it puts him definitively above the commanders. But as we can tell, as Queen fought Big Mom and Luffy fought Kaido, there is quite a huge gap between Yonkos and commanders, so there's a lot of space for Luffy to fill in between where he can't defeat a Yonko yet, but is still above a commander. This is kind of what I'm envisioning right now. Keep in mind, guys, that even though Luffy might have, throughout the course of this arc, the ability to tap into Force Haki, and he's had since Whole Cake Island the ability to use Future Sight, these abilities are not perfected yet. So using Shanks as an example, I speculated earlier, I think that he probably has Future Sight Hockey as well as Force Hockey. With his Future Sight, I think that Shanks could see much further into the future than Luffy and Katakuri could. That's sort of the upper echelon of what Luffy can hope to achieve with that ability. I don't think it's a thing where you just have the ability and then all of a sudden it's maxed out on stats. I don't think it works that way. So then Luffy has the potential to get stronger in these abilities. And I think this kind of thing matters, guys. The further that you can see into the future, the quicker that you can react and prepare for what is coming. And this is without mentioning his base hockey in the first place. As we could see in his fight versus Katakuri, Luffy's basic armament hockey did not appear to be as strong as Katakuri's. So using layman's terms here, Katakuri was harder than Luffy when using armament hockey. This is another thing that I just expect over time to get stronger and stronger. And so as it pertains to Wano and Luffy's advanced hockey right now, I think the biggest downside, the reason I think that Luffy right now cannot fight a Yonko is simply because Gear 4th. Gear 4th's time that Luffy is able to use it is obviously increasing. But it basically has to be indefinite, I think, in order to make a huge difference. Luffy could potentially fight on par or fight with a Yonko without losing automatically using Gear 4th and both types of advanced armament hockey, but eventually it'll end. And then Luffy will go back down to base physical stats, in which I think that Kaido and Big Mom have a huge advantage. And without the full mastery of the advanced hockey, Luffy might find it difficult in order to keep up. So we're not entirely sure whether or not Luffy is actually going to defeat a Yonko here in Wano. I think it is a very legit question, but I do think that he has to at least fight with them. And so Gear 4th plus Advanced Hockey could potentially do it. We can also consider Awakening. I think that this would be a good time for Luffy to somehow unlock Awakening. I'm not sure exactly what would cause that, but or what exactly it does for that matter, but it's surely going to make a difference. And obviously we are on the lookout. We are waiting for the potential Gear 5th. But as I've sort of said, since I first started my channel up until now, through Whole Cake Island, through Wano, my idea for how Wano is going to play out is that Luffy does not defeat Kaido. That defeating Kaido is a lot like defeating Ors from Thriller Bark, and it's a tag team effort with potentially a lot of very relevant characters, Supernova, Marines, other pirates, the Alliance, all of these people could play a role. So it's not necessarily important for Luffy to become truly Yonko level right now. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much my thoughts about how strong Luffy is right now and versus the Yonko commanders and Queen and versus the Yonko. As always, let me know what you think. Share your thoughts in the comment section below. Like the video if you like the video. Dislike the video if you dislike the video. Make sure to subscribe if you want to be notified for my future content. And as always, guys, have a wonderful day.